la 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 la.
I think it was the aims that drew me in. I had very limited idea about this course at that point of time, but AIIMS as an institution, being such a big name, I couldn't avoid joining it. And I had some faith, it's a new course, it was a new course, and I read about it, and I felt it was quite intriguing for me, and I thought it would be good enough. And I'm very happy today. I'm living my dream through SpHear at the moment. However, I really don't mind reaching out to more and more people across the country. And it's very much possible with the current technology today. It's possible. There's more demand than supply for an audiologist in this country. And it's a global phenomenon, very much in our country as well. In private sector, there's a decent salary that audiologists can earn. However, the challenge is in the government sector. The pay scale may not be as per as their qualification. They are well qualified. They are qualified for 4 years for graduation course and 2 years for post-graduation course. But the government sector is still not sorted out. They are still being paid, and I would say underpaid in the government sector. And that's how many good audiologists are draining out of the country. Because there, in the government sector, private sector, they have good respect and salary, and they're doing well. So that is the biggest challenge in our nation. However, the advent of new private organizations coming up in our country, like so many multinational companies coming up, setting up their clinics, chain of centers, they are seeking audiologists, and they're earning good there. They're getting an opportunity to learn. They're getting opportunity for international exposure in terms of, you know, their own learning, their professional growth. They are getting good scope here. However, it is still a handful of them. It has changed in terms that the audiologist, I feel, and speech therapist are more independent of other professionals. They are more independent in taking decision for their patients. They are more recognized by patients themselves. They are coming to them directly instead of being referred by other professionals. These are the positive changes I see for people who are doing private practice compared to what it was there in the past. Now professionals in speech and hearing are being recognized for what they are, what they do, and they're also recognized by other professionals as well as the people who are suffering with speech and hearing disorders. There is scope if one wants to do it. However, it is limited, but one can do it. Like for instance, I like to specialize myself. The clinic specializes in cochlear implants. We are not so much into hearing aids. However, the audiology work can be many, but we like to specialize in cochlear implants, and I'm very happy doing it because that's where my passion is, and it derives me immense happiness doing that job. So I personally feel there is a huge scope of provided people opt for it.